to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to do a first impressions on the Milani Conceal Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation Plus Concealer. I know I'm late on the bandwagon. I just recently was able to pick it up, so I got it. So that's why I'm trying it now for you guys. Just a quick disclaimer, if you don't like me, if you don't like my videos, don't watch them. Simple as that. So yeah, if you don't like me, you don't like my videos, you don't like, I don't know, my smile, the way I talk, my personality, don't watch me. It's literally that easy. If you guys would like to see my first impressions on this foundation, then go ahead and keep watching. I do half of my face using this Big Real Technique sponge. I got this at Walmart. It's like for the body makeup and stuff, but it's so fast to go on the face. So I'm going to use this for half my face, and then the other half I'm going to use this Crown Brush and BoxyCharm collaboration. So yeah, I already primed my skin. So let's just go ahead and start this. I think I'm going to start with the brush. I'm thinking I'm going to do the brush on this side. So it comes with a pump. I got the lightest shade, Creamy Vanilla 01. I'm hoping it matches me. Okay, it's really thick. I don't know if you can see that. Really thick. Okay, so I'm just gonna dip the brush into the foundation. Put some on there. Go ahead. Okay, so it's really good coverage. It's a little bit dark for me.
That's just because I'm
really freaking pale. I think I might like the way that it looks with a sponge instead of a brush. Only because it is so thick, but the coverage is really good. So far, I can still see like my freckles. But maybe if we try to build it up, it'll look better. I don't know if you can already tell the difference from both sides, but... the brush is kind of making it a little bit streaky, which I'm not enjoying. So you can still see some of my blemishes over there. I'm gonna just go over it with my sponge just to get the streaks out of there. Okay. So I feel like my pores are kind of a little more accentuated. It might be because it's so thick and maybe powder will fix that a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and use the sponge now. Just dip the sponge in there and just okay, so I already like how the sponge is applying better. Giving me more of a flawless finish. My face on this side compared to this side, my pores aren't as intense as they are on this side. I like how the sponge applies a lot better. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply a second layer. I can build up the coverage. Okay. So it's definitely buildable. It's kind of clinging on to my dry patches around my nose. I do like it so far. I like the coverage. My skin looks smooth besides where my dry patches are. shade too. Okay. So I'm just going to, I don't know, let's cake it on. I'm gonna just dot where I want a little bit more coverage. So like, I see some blemishes right there, so I'm just gonna dot some there, there, here on my nose. Okay, so I wanted to build it up some more just for the sake of the first impressions, and I wouldn't build it up any more than two layers, like even if you're just trying to spot conceal a little bit at the end, because it's starting to look a little cakey. Only around my dry spots though, and around my nostrils. Everywhere else looks pretty good actually. Really good coverage. I really like that. Okay, so I'm starting to form an opinion. Just give me 1 minute to finish the rest of my makeup and I will be right. So I finished up my makeup. If you guys want to see like my no makeup makeup look, this is it, besides like the more fuller coverage foundation. So just comment down below if you want to see that, and I will definitely film that for you. But as far as the foundation goes, I forgot to tell you what the claims are. It says medium to full coverage. I agree. It's definitely buildable as well. And then it says lightweight, oil-free formula. It's lightweight, but because my skin's so dry, I can feel it on my skin. Which isn't, it's not the best thing ever for me. I like to not be able to feel it, but I can feel it, and it's not something that I will like. It's not something I can't deal with, you know? So that I don't necessarily agree with, but that could be just because of my skin type. And then it says that it's long wearing, water resistant, and sweat proof. So I'm not gonna do like check-ins or anything, but I will put in the description box on how it wore, because I am gonna wear it all day. I'm just not gonna do check-ins. So I'll let you know how long I wore it for, what happened, if it broke up around my nose or whatever. I will put all the details in the description box. But as for right now, let me do look up. All of my makeup blended really nicely on top of it, and my skin like actually looks flawless. I think it looks absolutely flawless. Everything looks smooth. It's not tacky. I did set it a little bit like with a really really light layer of powder, but it's really smooth. It's not tacky. Everything blended beautifully on top of it. None of my products messed up the formula or anything like that. Yeah, I really love how my skin looks right now. I really really like it, so hopefully it is long wearing like it says. Because if so, then I will be getting a lot of use out of this, because I can get past the heavy feeling. Yeah, I really love how this looks. I think I might do a little zoom in for you guys so you can see my skin up close. So I'm very up close and personal. I don't know if you can see this, but you can see like my little blemish right here. You can see some of my freckles peeking through, but like when I'm back here, it looks flawless. My pores, you can't really see them. Once I powdered it, it kind of made them look like more invisible. I can't see my pores very much at all. It is a little cakey around my nostrils, but all the foundations do that to me, so I mean, that's no big deal. So yeah, I really, really like this foundation, and if you guys like this video, go ahead and subscribe, comment down below. If you've tried this, if you like it, if you hate it, just comment down below and let me know. I really would like to know. Don't forget to check out the subscription box. I will put what highlighter I'm using, what bronzer I'm using, all that kind of stuff down there. I'll put all that in the description box, so don't forget to check that out and comment down below if you tried it. Just let me know. I want to know. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell if you want to be notified whenever I post, and yeah, I will see you all in my next video. Bye!